God's love to me. Normally when I talk about God, I'm not so nice to him, but he slapped me. So I was hit by lightning. So I just want to explain a little bit about it and then go to current electricity. Which class were you by then? Which class were you in 2011? In 2011, which class were you? If you were allowed to watch TV, you must have watched me explaining about lightning. So I became a celebrity, explained about lightning. When I had in 2012, I was like feeling Superman. So I remember in December 2012, I was on UBC TV, then UBC radio. I even had been given the recording of our show by the show host because he was so happy of how I explained. So he even gave me a tape. So I went home and I listened to it for some time. So on this date, on this day here, it tried to rain today in the morning. And for me, I never used to give a damn whether it rains cats and dogs, I would go to work. So I opened my door, my camera here. By then I had a smaller camera, my phone in the hall, listening to my favorite radio station. And then I had my computer in standby mode in my bag. So I went out of the house with my umbrella until when I felt it was becoming so windy. So I tried to run. The next thing I felt was like someone had held me by the feet and another one by the head, and they were pressing me. Because eventually I got pain here. I can't carry heavy stuff. But I don't care, I got another lease of life. So me, I'm in my bonus life. That's why none of you can really piss me off, and I get annoyed after that, I'm like. So if you want to get a feeling of how it feels, it's like if you have ever been near big speakers, like these people who advertise concerts, and you are near that vehicle, and then it gets a malfunction like that. That feeling you get as if they have smacked you, or like the system has got a problem, like it has got like that sound it makes, but you feel as if they are hammering you in the middle of the this part here. So I felt like it was near a gate along the perimeter wall. So it hit me and I fell this way, and I remember I was paralyzed like this and I couldn't feel my hands. So I yelled like if you're Muslim, forgive me, I yelled like a pig. Unfortunately in Uganda I don't know. So I remember when I gained some blood, when blood started flowing and I gained blood flow, I was talking to myself, I'm just speaking by this. So when I reached the parking, I told the young man, "You are talking to a ghost. I've just been hit by lightning, the one at the parking." So I put on the lights to go show him how my father was, and the pot was full of mud. So his friend came and scooped some blood in. So, "But you are bleeding." And I wasn't feeling nothing. I was feeling okay. I wasn't having headache. I wasn't feeling any pain. I was okay. That's why when you get an accident, they grab you. You may run away and die there. You may be badly injured, but you don't feel nothing. And then you run into the bush. And before they come to rescue you, you've already bled out of blood. So that's when I get scared, because when I looked like this, the whole shirt here was full of blood. And on my head, on my height here, here I had a Y. A Y here like this. I have a Y here. When I took my my head. This time I'll drop it flat so that when I come, I drop it.
My scar.
In other words, one thing I learned is that do as you say. You cannot say, you also do as you say. Don't say, do as I say, not as I do. Because the rules were that if it is rumbling out in the skies are rumbling, don't get out of the house. When you are caught up in a pinch, squat and remain there. It is better to be wet than being hit by. And for me, I was like, as if I'm invisible, let me go to work. So how does this happen? We don't, this possibly doesn't, but in S2 you covered it, in S2 and also when you go to Nelcon, you find it, and when you watch, there's one where Walter Lemon actually explains it better. So normally when the evaporation takes place, the moisture goes up, the higher you go, the cooler it becomes, and then you get freezing particles. When these particles freeze, they start moving and then eventually, you know, turn into pieces because of the dynamics. So when that happens, the bigger pieces come here, and those bigger pieces are known to be negatively charged. The positive ones, which are smaller, remain up to upper part of the cloud. So there are many types of lightning. There is one which is intra cloud, cloud to cloud, and then cloud to ground. There is no ground to ground. So the objects, either a tree or a building or the swaggerific me that day, when we are on earth. That's why they say you put on rubber shoes. I really had nice rubber shoes by that time. I think that's why I got set. By now, and I no one would believe that I had been hit by lightning. They would say they hit him and then, but because even if when I even told some people, they said, no, are you sure someone will either shot you or hit you with an iron bicycle? Because I didn't even go, I never got swollen. When I reached the clinic, I told the guy, the doctor, he was a young man. I said, I've been hit by lightning. He looked at me like this. He said, you see there? He didn't express any, like, he said, you see there. He didn't mind. So he went, brought the laser, chopped off the whatever. Then later on, he told me to lie down. He squeezed down the blood so there's no clot. After that, he stitched me. After stitching me, he said, can we put you on a drip? And I said, no, I feel some pain after hearing like a pig. I got my jaws cut. I'm going to go and take some splash juice. So the tablets, I remember the painkillers they gave me to just reduce on the pain. And that's it. And the small thing he would put on the wound. I never got that serious. So what happens is that these negatives here will repel all the negative charges and they go into the earth through you. And then these positive charges will hang in there in the building. And then you also, when you are walking around, you walk with positive charges hanging on the building. So on an event that there is some slight short circuit between any of these objects with the cloud, then you get what you normally see that happens when you are welding, when people are welding. You see that flash. Because it is merely just getting one side of the metallic piece you are welding, you connect it to the grounding, you hold the other positive part, that's where you put the rod, and then you short circuit. When you short circuit, because of the high current, you melt the welding rod, and then you make a joint. So when you are welding, you see that light, which actually spoils the eye, that's the lightning. The pop, 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 that sound that pops when you are welding is the thunder. So when you hear thunder, don't worry, you have already survived. It's like a bullet. A bullet moves at 700 meters per second. So when you hear boom, boom, just touch yourself to see whether you have blood. But you are not shot at least on the face or whatever. When you hear a bullet sound, you are okay. Don't fear. Just continue hearing. Okay, so let me finish here. So just like how welding takes place, the welding, how it takes place, that's the same stuff. So you have tens of thousands of amperes in between here. So and our bodies can only sustain up to the maximum of 1 ampere. Beyond 1 ampere, you are dead. So you can imagine if you have 10,000, 10,000 is 10 to the power 4, 10,000 amps going through you, you get roasted like fish and remain there like this. Of course, lying down. I think I could have gotten maybe, I don't know, I still don't know how my head split, because I never fell on the wall. So next, in the future, I want to buy cameras around myself so that I go. So how do we prevent this? How we prevent this is that if you are just this guy here, you just fall. So you get as near to the earth as possible. If you are having this building, you put there what we call lightning arrestor, which is a copper rod here with spikes, and then here gets connected to an aluminum or copper plate which goes up to the ground. In the ground here, you put there a copper mesh, or what some people call a copper mat, or just a big copper rod, you bury it there and connect this one on it. Sometimes they put charcoal, because charcoal attracts moisture. And when it attracts moisture, it means if it is moist, any electrons coming from above the building will be easily conducted through to the soil, which is earth. If it is a rod, and also sometimes they put salt as well, salt keeps, you know, attracting, making it wet around the place. So the conductivity becomes easier. So the event that you have positives on these spikes, due to corona discharge, they keep being discharged and then keep neutralizing some of the negatives from the ground. So you reduce on this current here that you have, the potential difference, the potential difference created because of this separation of charges would reduce because of the ones which are, you can imagine our building having a connector here, having a connector, you have all those positive charges always going to the clouds and neutralizing at all. So, but on the event that all of them are neutralized and then these negatives now start coming, they will flow quickly to the earth and not spoil anything. They won't spoil the building, they won't spoil anything. But if the building has no lightning conductor, the positives will hang in there. The negatives will come on the event that you have now, the drizzle coming up, and then they won't have anywhere to go, and then they will burn up the building. So you will say the building has been struck by lightning. You see big smoke. Now what happens when you go under the tree? Like you say, let me take the shade under the tree. The tree will get those positive charges there. Will excite the whole environment around you, but the tree is not a good conductor as your body. So you will become the only path for the electrons. So you are under the tree, it hits you. That's why they say don't take a shape under the tree. Only take shape in a secure building, a safe building. Because you heard of the kids who were struck when they are in a classroom. It's not that any building is safe. No. Then that's why they encourage them to put on knee gainer if you can't afford nice rubber shoes. just to make sure that you have insulation, you are not being a path to these electrons or these charges to the plant. Don't joke with me. I know how it feels when God gets annoyed and decides to slap you. So his hands are very tough. He slapped me and I got.
The interesting part is that a couple of months before that, yes, month, I think either a month or a year, because in 2011 I've been on radio and I didn't know that when they hosted me, I didn't know my other co-hosts. I mean, are they co-guests? So they brought this old man who believes in the cultural things. So they started. The Buganda spirits are annoyed. There's a lot of prostitution. There is stealing. So I asked him, you mean your Buganda spirits go up to Musoga? Because by then there was an incident in one of the schools in Musoga. I said, you mean your spirits leave the sluts who are lousing in Kampala, now they are going to Musoga and Chibata. Why don't they first, work on these ones here? So I got worried. If it had happened like the next few days, I would have said this man is peace. But you can be hit by lightning anywhere if you don't take precautions. When it, like today, when it rained a bit where I stay, and I heard the skies rumbling, I was like, now am I going to miss my lecture? Because I wouldn't give a damn, I wouldn't come. Now my bonus life is more important than you guys. Okay, any questions about lightning? And lightning is a scientific phenomenon. It is electrostatics, purely. There is no chicken which runs away when the lightning has hit someone. And I don't believe in those guys who say they can make thunder and it hits. If they are there, I will give them money. Yes, you have Well, the idea is that you are safer than having, like maybe me, these charges could have gone through me, but maybe the funder was so not passable somewhere, and then they decided to disappear through my head. I don't know. I've never, and I'm lucky that I still think right, although when I overread stuff, I get some headache, so I take a lot of water, but I'm normal, I'm okay. And so the shoes help in that you won't be a conducting surface. You won't be a conducting, if you are on bare, this electron will just come and say, here is where to pass, we are going home. And if they come through you, you can't sustain the current. You get shocked. Some are lucky like me that you fall there, they see you shaking, they say these are their spirits. But when it is because of the current. And when we reach current electricity, because of that, the frequency. That's why when you touch the light wire, you are like, because you are having to and fro of the current, from here to Ginger Bar, 50 times a second. So when you touch, you're like, if it is 50 hertz, you are shaking because the current is going back and coming. So here it will hit you and you fall down and you become stuck like this. Say, this one is inductive. Oh, these are the spirits which are. So there is no to do in lightning. That one I disclaim it. It is science, and when you take precautions, you won't have any issues.
Doctor, can you have the storage for moving that the current and the lightning causes? For example, if you get a very big battery and connect it to the lightning
charge, fine. Charging is a process. That's why in that experiment you wait. You switch on and you start looking at your time. The T is equal to RC. This one is an instant. In a few seconds, you are dead. It has already discharged.
It's like how you are welding. When you are welding, you don't put there like, ooh, no. You just put, it has already made, it has already melted. So a good welder may even weld stuff in 5 minutes, is done. And you can't make it touch for more than maybe 5 seconds. So the problem is that charging takes a, you have to align, you are realigning the dipole moments, electric dipole moments within your battery, and takes a process, takes some time. You wait until it is done. Now this one is instant. How are you going to capture this instant power and save it? Everyone would have, these whites would have made sure that every storm they have that big charge store, and you can't. And you also risk being hit because you are not in control. Benjamin is my, like I say, I don't know whether it is you, maybe there. Benjamin Franklin is my colleague in this struggle of lightning. He was busy using a kite because he's the one who discovered the lightning conduct. The president of the United States, former, he was doing the experiment. He was a scientist. So he was putting the kite up to see how the lightning, and it hit him like me. So I have contemporaries in that. That field, yes?
The question on that, like you as a person, when you are putting on rubber shoes, and that's when you're doing the walking, so it's going down?
No, but it is not, you are not even, even if you have rubber shoes, you don't go with swag because you have rubber shoes.
That's what I was saying.
It can still hit you and, you know, cause you problems. But you hear what you're saying?
Like when I squat down, when it's raining, and because I want these irons to come and they pass through me, they can go to the
No, 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 you are not doing that. The reason for you to squat is that you are reducing the chance of you being the highest object around. I have drawn these diagrams near each other, as you can see the house is here, but if you were walking in a pitch and you are the only guy who is tall, it means you are the guy who is having all those positive charges. So you are up there like this. So you are the only chance for these electrons to find where to go. Because they will come, they will try the two positives that have been on your head, and then they say, where are we going? We can't go back. They want to go home, which is the arm. And then they just say, let's go through this guy. Even if you have rubber shoes, you will still be in problem. But it reduces the connection between you and the earth. So if you are on a name, that's why, because of climate change, we have had now the prevalence. And my advice was that each of the schools could start putting there some trees to reduce of that. So the going down is to say, let the trees far away also be the ones who begin to slowly be down. So trees are always, if you go in a forest, these forest fires, I mean bush fires in the United States, and like most of them are caused by lightning. It hits one tree, then the spark, the tree burns up, and the whole stuff just burns up. Some of them. Yes.
How about this kind of
noise? I think noise is not for lightning but for a tornado. That the tornado could be explained because tornado is a swirl. When water is swirling towards the ground or something like the way it was on Lake Bunyonyi, when you make noise, sound is you are making the air waves to vibrate. I mean air particles vibrate. And if you had that swirling somewhere, the whole village makes noise. You interfere with the air around, so it would break up the swirling water. That's my, because in the village we never used to have, when a tornado would kind of want to fall, we just get jelly cans, whatever, and we make noise. The red is that if you make statistics, you find that nice pure red will be silk. And silk is electrostatic. If you are ironing silk, and you have hairy legs like mine, you'll never see them to prove whether they are or not. When you have ironed one pattern, it is the what you are ironing is going down like this, you feel the hair is being attracted. So my explanation on that is that most nicely worked on red stuff. The red stuff you find that is really red, most of them are silk, and they have electrostatic property. So you are having these charges being formed about you, and you are now electrostatic everywhere. So you become more potential to be struck. Yes, and then there is one final one. What year was that? It must be a long time, because before AFMs became so monotonous, I think, when was the first FM radio established? I think it was either Capital or Sanyo. But anyhow, when you are listening to shortwave radio, was it a shortwave or medium wave or FM? Okay. So, but for a shortwave radio, what happens is that you have what we call ionospheric. This is called the ionosphere. This is our earth. Normally what happens is that this tower here, you know, produces the radio waves, and then we mirror you somewhere here. I am able to pick up the signal because of what we call total inner reflection. So when the waves reach the ionosphere is a region in space where you find an equal amount of electrons and positive charged ions. When the ozone gets split, get oxygen, then an electron, ozone gets split into oxygen, and then the oxygen gets into two oxygen ions and two electrons. Now when you have these positive charges and negative charges in big numbers, which normally multiplies when you have like sunlight has come up now, it multiplies. The ionosphere gets enlarged. That's why during the day, the reception of the analog TV by then was fed. Because now you will have, when you enlarge this, it means that the angle reduces, and meaning that it will come in the other place. So the if you were in Kololo, the waves won't go far away. In the night at around midnight, those days of analog TV, when you are watching Champions League on UTV, now UBC, around beyond midnight, the picture will be clear, very calm. The reason was not because it is at night and it is dark. It's because the ionosphere would have received it, so it would have gone a little bit up. And that means if it goes up, this wave will be able to go as far as possible. Because lightning is an electrostatic phenomenon, your radio will always do chsh. You hear some sound in chsh. That's one. Two, these waves are coming to your radio. They are also electrostatic. So if you leave your radio there and it is talking, and there are waves coming to your radio, then you are at risk. That's why they say when it is raining and there's lightning, switch off your electronics. Because you will now be any overload. That's why even remember switches off. Apart from the branches falling or the light, you can have an overload of your transmission line from lightning. It's a lightning, these are charges. which are lurking around. So they find other charges in a transmission line, they will join on, and then you have an overall transformer and blasts into flames. So the reason was because of that. One, you want to enjoy the radio energy. It is raining, it is shouting, if you are in a glass thatch house, fine. You find there is no noise. But if you are in an iron sheet house with a fake ceiling, our house didn't have a ceiling, so I don't know about ceilings. I know ceilings of these days. So you have that sound of rain, you can't hear nothing. So it's better to switch off and save batteries. But also, the interference. Every time you see the light, because you are having the charges interfering with these waves. Like I told you, have you done that experiment anyway? When you go under high tension power transmission line, you can't get a reception of, even if it is an FM station, some of them just black out. You don't hear nothing. So this is how transmission happens. These days, life has become easier. What happens is that star times or signet will take everything across this ionosphere and take it to what we call a satellite. And the satellite, through its transponder, sends everywhere, because these satellites are what we call in the parking, which you have done in your mechanics. And parking orbit is like, if this chop was a satellite and I'm the earth, when I'm spinning, I'm the earth. When I'm spinning, the satellite moves at the same time, around with the same period. So the satellite will always be looking at the same point. That's why we call it geostationary. It keeps looking at the same your position. So communication becomes easy. It means that as long as you are moving, anything that is coming from that satellite still gives me the information. I get Al Jazeera, I get CNN from it all the time. On the same spot. That's why satellite communication or digital migration, that's why TVs are very bright, very clear. Compared to this ionospheric communication, you find this wave also will come to this TV. Now I change the TV. Then there is a tree here. So this one comes and hits the tree, also comes to my TV. That's why at times you will find that you have like three people in one reading news. So when you turn the radio, you start seeing these three people coming, becoming one. Because of Malpath, because of this wave which was coming from here, this one which got reflected at this point, reflected at that point, all came to radio, and we are giving those Malpath images, which doesn't happen in a digital transmission. Digital transmission, either the image is there, or you see a dark screen and it says no, signal. This is not what I should do. We need this one another process. So let's do something about selling currents. I saw your hand, but maybe I explained it when I was. You still have it? Shoot, so that I.
We know that many charges inside the chapel.
They do what?
Inside the chapel itself, in the same place.
Many?
Okay, there is inside charges at chapel.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, for people are moving other way, and maybe I'm covering myself in another way, we try to have created more. One surface area, such as I'm looking by right.
Yo, that's what I have an umbrella on me. But here is the problem. This is the umbrella, but it has this sharp point. So you have more charges there. And then you have, most likely, you are lucky that, not most likely, this also is metal. Which is actually connected here,
Maybe you are lucky, it has a, not lucky, they have to put an insulator here. Otherwise, everyone would be in trouble. So all I remember is that when I tried to run, because it felt a bit like it was being windy, you know, I wanted to understand it, but the more I wanted to understand it, the more I remembered the pain. So I left it to go. I wanted to understand what happened exactly to me. But when I remember the circumstances, I feel a bit, the pain I went through is not easy. So these are just normally most umbrellas. This is cloth, isn't it? So it is not advisable actually to have an umbrella when you are in this way, because the sharp point is even helping on creating, releasing more charges and attracting more to your part. So the more they come and now they have finished what you have created and they want to go somewhere, most likely I must have hit the umbrella wrongly, and then one of the metallic guards or metallic whatever they call them must have been the one which touched my this other head. I can't know what happened. So you are not safe either with the umbrella. Actually, you are more unsafe because you are giving out more charges to attract the other charges. And you are helping the language group for how to go in home. Yeah. You can think of more stuff. Go to Helicon, read that part. Go to Abbot and read that part of Lightning so that you can explain. I can assure you many people. When I was surprised, me, I was just explaining a small electrostatic phenomenon. These journalists were like as if I am, and I was lucky when they came. We had bought a lightning conductor, it was in my office, awaiting to put it up on the building. So I was like, I got it, explained these are spies, put them on, then I put it on the rod. So it was as if I'm from Mars. This team came, when they took a report, the other one came, generals came, I said, this country is in problems. So they went through school. The thing they were taught in S2, they can't even remember a thing. Same applied when, in 2013, when they, eventually I went for this eclipse. Eclipse, which you draw in senior, in primary 5. You draw the umbra, the penumbra. But they were asking as if it is some animal which is coming to Pakwach. And also enjoyed the nice moment. Because in the pitch in Pakwach, I was the one in the middle of the pitch, the Mike Effect telescope. And the president is there waiting for me to announce when this is going to happen. When I tell you the story of how I went to Pakwach and ended up in the middle of the pitch, football pitch, where the president is, they sent him to my telescope. I don't want to tell you what he said. And when he came there, I tried to show him. And then eventually, later on, the clouds went on the covered the place where the sun was. That was my toughest moment in life. I'm sure if it was a meeting, you would have shot me. My telescope was on that camera stand facing the sun. I'm standing here. When that happened, all the people around turned, now we are facing me. I remember just having my hand doing like this. I'm trying to remove the clouds. Because I mean everyone is looking at me as if I'm the one who has caused it. Unfortunately, after a few minutes, then the skies opened up. Then it happened. After it happened like this, they didn't even wait to see what happens later. Everyone now wanted now to go back home. But it was the nicest moment. A
at the end of the day that you are the one who, because whatever I told them would happen, happened the way it happened. I'm not a genius. I had to read on the internet and understand how it works. That's how I came to start doing the moon viewing. Because I found out people don't really know how the moon works. So I said I can now give moon viewing events every other month. So those who want to remain stupid can remain stupid. But those who want to understand something can come and learn. I'm also tired.